and it's time for some DIY.
Why?
Because we love it.
Shaka guys, and welcome to my show. You know what's tomorrow? It's Charlie Chaplin's birthday. So guess what? I'm gonna relax tomorrow, play some movies, and just have a great time. And what goes well with movies? Let me think. Pizza! That's right. So I'm gonna order me some pizza. Hello? Yeah, I would like to have... Okay, I'm done with my movies and the pizza. Now what do I do with my time? Wait a minute, I have an idea. So to make this, you need full stomach, an empty box, and a few more things. Here's a list. Okay, so let's begin. So for Charlie Chaplin's birthday, I'm using this empty pizza box and making a Charlie Chaplin wall clock. So first, we're going to use this box, make some markings, then pour some cement in this and make the structure of my wall clock. So let's make some markings. And with the help of these diagonal lines, we will get the center of this box right here. Once you have the center, we'll take scissors and cut the top flap. Now just fold the box again, maintaining the same shape like this, and then use some sticking tape and lock all the sides. Okay, so our box is nicely sealed with the tape, and I'll show you how you can fix the clock mechanism to this box. Okay, so first we'll remove the battery. Now we'll carefully remove the hands. Now we need to make a box which is exactly the same size of our piece right here. So I'll take the top flap of the pizza box, keep this piece on it, and take some rough measurement. Okay, so I have this piece now, but before I make this into a box, we will just find the center of this as well. So I'm using a strip of box board. You can also take card paper, basically any paper which is thick enough so that it doesn't get wrinkled when we pour cement mix on it, but also can be bent easily. Okay, let's stick this. There you go, we have a box and this fits perfectly in it. Now we need to make a hole right in the middle. And this hole should be big enough so that a straw can pass through it easily, like this. The straw will basically provide you a cavity for this part to come out where you will attach the hands of the clock. So you need to measure the height of this. So now I have the marking here and we'll fix this straw in the middle of our pizza box right here. So first we'll pour some inside the straw and then just fix it right in the middle. Once it's fixed, we need to pour our cement mix in this. I'm wearing gloves for protection. Now we'll get the cement in. Now we pour some water. There is no fixed proportion, guys, so you have to keep adding little water and keep mixing so that there are no lumps. Okay, as you can see, I have a nice thick consistency here, almost like chocolate pudding. Sadly, you can't eat it. Okay, let's push this aside and get our pizza box in. Now very carefully, you have to keep putting the cement mix in the pizza box. You need to gently tap it like this so that there are no air bubbles and also so that it becomes flat. Press it in each corner. Okay, now we need to add the box. So I'll take the gloves off. Pass it through the straw and press it down and keep pressing it. You can see here we have reached the black outline that I had done. Once you have reached the outline, just release it. Now you need to keep it aside and you need to wait for 10 hours to 12 hours for this to dry up completely. Because it's gonna take so long, I have kept one ready, which is nice and dry. Now, carefully remove the tape. Okay, I've opened all the sides. Now, let's gently remove this. Okay, so I've removed it from the box. Let's get some newspaper in and let's place it and see. There you go, that's the center from where our mechanism will come out. So let's remove this box. There you go. You have a nice clean passage here and behind you have a nice clean cavity. Okay, after you take it out from the box, you still need to keep it in the sun to dry for another 10 to 12 hours so that the cement dries up completely. So I have one which is ready, I'll show you. And here you go. You can see this piece is nice and dry and I have brushed off all the flaky cement that was on it. So the pizza box helped us make this shape and base for a wall clock. Now we need to add the Charlie Chaplin bit. For that, I have taken a printout from the net. Now we'll cut it cleanly. Okay, we have a nice clean cutout. Now I'll show you how you can attach this to the wall clock mechanism. So we'll leave the cutout aside. First, we'll flip this. So let's fix this mechanism in this cavity. For that, I'm using some double-sided tape to lock it in place. Okay, so the foam tape will help our mechanism stay in place. Once that is done, flip it over. Now we'll take the Charlie Chaplin cutout and we need to place it right on top of this mechanism. Okay, so our cutout is ready. We need to stick the body in place. I'm applying some white glue. Okay, once the body is in place, we need to use a marker or some acrylic color and fill up the bottom area so that when the legs overlap, it shouldn't look empty. So I'm just extending the body a little bit. Once that is done, you can take the hands, first the small hand, and we'll fix one leg on it. And the same thing we'll do for the other leg. Okay, now that the hands are in place, let's put in the battery. There you go. And Charlie is alive. See, I told you, movies and pizza are a great combination. And whenever they come together, you have an awesome time. If you're also a fan of Charlie Chaplin, then let me know which one of his movies is your favorite. Also, in the comment section, let me know if you enjoyed this video or if you have any ideas or suggestions or stars or celebrities in mind that you want me to incorporate in my DIYs. Connect with me on Instagram and Facebook. Send me some of your intro links that I can add in my videos. All the details are in the description below. I'll see you next time with some more DIYs. Until then, do good and be good. Peace.